In this video, we will be seeing the installation of Oracle GoldenGate. So basically, these are the operating system requirements that you need while you configure Oracle GoldenGate. So you need 50 to 150 MB free disk space to install the Oracle GoldenGate software on the database or on the operating system. And for the trial files, you need 10 MB. For one trial file, it basically takes 10 MB. There will be multiple trial files that will be created, and you can always use purge old extracts to basically delete those trial files that are already synced, right? So these are the disk requirements: 150 to 50 MB to 150 MB for the disk space and 10 MB for each trial file. So altogether, if you have say 10 GB of space, you can install Oracle GoldenGate. Then you will need the network configuration. You need TCP by IP configuration, that is Transmission Control Protocol / Internet Protocol for using the network. So through this network, the data is transferred from your source database to target database. And you need some ports, those free ports that you need to basically configure your manager processes. So your manager processes use these free ports, and using these ports, the data is transmitted from your source database to target database using TCP by IP protocol. So in brief, these are the operating system requirements. Then how to download Oracle GoldenGate? Oracle GoldenGate can be downloaded from the Oracle website using the credentials. We will be actually installing Oracle GoldenGate 11 on the Linux machine. Why are we using Linux machine? As I have already mentioned in the previous videos, we are using Linux machine because Oracle database is widely used on Linux platform. Oracle database works on Windows platform as well, but Oracle as a database is considered to be safe and secure on a Linux platform. So we will be installing a 11G R2 database on a Linux machine, and then we will be installing GoldenGate on it. We have already seen the prerequisite steps wherein we install the Oracle 11G Release 2 database on a Linux machine. Now we will be installing Oracle GoldenGate on that machine. And as you know, we will see the GoldenGate software command interface. It is an interface using which we communicate with the Oracle database using GoldenGate commands. We will see a small demonstration of this GoldenGate software command interface followed by the installation of Oracle GoldenGate. Let's now see how do we download Oracle GoldenGate software 11G from Oracle eDelivery. So after you log in into eDelivery, this is how it looks like. You can go into product and start typing GoldenGate. So you need to select the Oracle GoldenGate in the product, and then you need to select the platform. So which is the operating system in which we would be installing Oracle GoldenGate? It is Linux 64-bit. So select Linux x86 64 and then continue. Here you will see you have the Oracle GoldenGate for Oracle 12c. So select the alternate release wherein you can select 11.111.0 for Linux x86 64, right? So now you have three files for Oracle GoldenGate 11g, that is 11.111.0. Click on continue. Accept the agreement. Click on continue. Here you can see that you have three files. One is for 10g, one is for 11g, and one is for 9i. So we need to download the second file, that is v28941-01.zip. So this is the file that we will need to download so that we can install Oracle GoldenGate on 11G for Linux 64-bit machine. Click on download, and it is going to download your software. So this is a download manager using which you can download the software from eDelivery. So you can store the file. I'll be storing it in my D drive. This is a software v28941-01. Click on save. And it is going to download the software for you. After the GoldenGate software is downloaded, we will now have to transfer the software to the
first server, that is where we have our first database, which is source, SRCE, right? So the server name is 192.168.56.101. So we will be using WinSCP to transfer the software into this server. So we'll be transferring the software to U01 location. And the software is located in your D drive. So this is the zip which we downloaded. It is the Oracle GoldenGate software for Linux 64-bit for 11G. Drag and drop. So the software is now copied to the U01 location. Let's unzip the software, but before we unzip, let's create the Golden Gate directory home using mkdir ggs11.1, or we can just make it ggs11. Move the software, or you can rather copy the software into ggs11. And then you can unzip the software here. So once the software is unzipped, you will see a list of files. So this is your tar file in which you have Golden Gate. You can untar it using tar command, tar-xvof. Right. So now these are the binaries of your Oracle Golden Gate. So this is your Oracle Golden Gate home, which is U01GGS11. In this directory, you have copied the software. Once you unzip the software, you get a tar file. And once you unzip the tar file, you get the binaries. So these are your Oracle Golden Gate binaries. After you have untarred the tar file, we need to do few settings. You need to export the path. So this is what your path is going to be, and export your LD library path, setting it to Oracle Golden Gate home. Now you can run the GGSCI, which stands for Golden Gate Software Command Interface, right? So once you set the path and once you export the library path, you can run Golden Gate Software Command Interface, from where you can do the setup. You need to repeat the same steps into the second server where you have your target database. In the second Linux server, you need to copy the software file, and then you need to unzip it, you need to untar it, and then similarly, by setting the path and by setting the library path, make sure you are able to log in into Golden Gate Software Command Interface, using which we will be running all our Golden Gate commands.